Thank you. 1921. But it was in 1874 when brothers Thomas and Andrew Chirnside commissioned the building of this stately mansion and its surrounding gardens when Werribee really reached acclaim. We'll tell you more about the Chirnsides after we finish in this room, the library, which contains the portrait of Andrew Chirnside above the fireplace. Portraits of Andrew's wife, Mary, and Andrew's brother, Thomas, can be found on the walls of the main staircase. The library, like the billiard room, was considered to be a male retreat, a place for the gentlemen of the house. The colours in this room are quite dark, giving the room a masculine feel. The fireplace is made of black marble, in contrast to the white marble fireplace in the drawing room, which was considered to be a female domain. The statues on the mantelpiece reflect Thomas and Andrew's love of hunting. The gasolier light fitting, the coal box, and the carpet are original to the mansion. 1880s, mansion dining room was used for formal entertaining. Dame Nellie Melba, one of Australia's most famous opera singers, is known to have been one of the many important guests to have dined at the original 16-foot pollard oak dining table. The table in the centre of the room is not original to the mansion. The original table would have been covered by a damask tablecloth, and the centre of the table would have been adorned with elaborate centrepieces, much like the ones on display today. The walls in this room are hung with paintings bought by Thomas Chirnside himself. On a visit to London in June 1881, Thomas attended a Christie's auction house sale and acquired, for the sum of £823.04, a ready-made collection of old masters. According to the 1890 inventory, there were a total of 33 paintings in the mansion. Today, 20 remain, including 8 of those bought in 1881. The walls were painted an apple green to complement the original dinner set on display. The pollard oak sideboard and the dinner wagon is original to the mansion. And in the 1880s, the sideboard carried a large selection of gold and silver racing trophies, won by famous Chirnside-owned horses in races such as the Melbourne Cup. The light fitting is also original and is one of the finest in the house. It is made of bronze in the Egyptian style and includes matching wall brackets. The morning room was used as an informal family living and dining room, as opposed to the dining room and drawing room, which were reserved for more formal occasions. The paintings in this room, with the exception of the still life on the right of the fireplace, were bought by Thomas Chirnside. The furniture is original to this room, with the exception of the chairs. The maroon leather Chesterfield couch was donated by the son of Mr. Nathby, who worked for George Chirnside, one of Andrew's sons. Mr. Nathby was still working for the Chirnside family when he was quite old and suffering from ill health. According to a personal account, George Chirnside gave Mr. Nathleen the Chesterfield couch so that he could have somewhere to lie down in the daytime. It is said that George Chirnside sent this Chesterfield couch to him, saying, "Look after that, Nathleen. It will be valuable one day." Both the dining room and morning room wooden floors have parquetry borders, which were probably made by arrowsmiths of London. Large quantities of this style of parquetry were imported into Australia in the late 19th century.
Watchmaker and engraver who had learned his craft in Edinburgh, Scotland. He emigrated as a priest to Sydney in 1824, where he set up his services in business. In May 1829, he was convicted on charges of
Hey, Charlie, can you do a sign there for me?
The billiard room was the focal point of the bachelor's wing. In the 1880s, this section of the mansion was considered a male domain. This room is also interesting as it contains
you.
philosophy and theology. In this room is original, except for the half-tester bed, which was reproduced. The carpet and textiles are reproductions of similar 19th century items by Colfax and Fowler of London. All the guest bedrooms in the mansion were equipped with washstands and appropriate double sets of washstandware. Bathing was carried out in the bedrooms. Slop pails were used in each room and were hidden from view. They were often kept in the space under the washstand. A towel rail was also a common feature of the guest bedrooms. It was used to carry very long towels with decorated fringed ends. In the late 19th century, all the bedrooms in the mansion, with the exception of the blue bedroom at the end of the corridor, were also commonly used as sitting rooms and contained a number of seats, a writing table, and small armchairs. renovation of the blue bedroom was made easier by information contained in the 1890 inventory and by the discovery of a description of the room in the fascinating letter written by a young girl named Violet Weatherly, who visited Werribee Park in November 1896. 13 pieces of the original bird's eye maple bedroom suite were discovered in various rooms of the house and have since been restored and reunited in this suite. The Wedgwood Gasolier.